On Thursday, Faker Pharmacy, one of the biggest pharmacies in the country, was served with a notice of closure by the National Drug Authority. The authority indicated that Faker was operating illegally without a license, and a notice was put out to the public alerting them about the action that had been taken. According to Medad Bitecherezo, board chairman for the National Drug Authority, the pharmacy had not adhered to the stipulated requirements.
The management tells me Faker doesn't have a license. When you run a pharmacy without a license and somebody gets a problem, how do we manage it?
In its defense, Faker Pharmacy put out a notice indicating that NDA had surveyed their premises in December 2017 and gave them a green light to operate.
If they don't have the license, they don't have the license. When they buy the license, they will be open.
Bitecherezo says that the crackdown will still go on. The Minister of Health says the crackdown on the pharmacies shows progress in cleaning up the health sector.
Now we have gotten a heightened surveillance, and all this information is coming because NDA is actually doing its work.
It is suspected that some pharmacies deal in illegal medicines. According to Dr. Charles Solaro, the Director of Clinical Services in the Health Ministry, efforts are being made to change the state of affairs.
And as a country, there are laws and regulations of accessing products. But definitely the people use ungazetted routes to access the supplies to the country. So we really want to urge that as a community, if you get anything which is suspicious, then give us the information.
Many Ugandans who visit health centers, especially those run by government, complain of lack of even the most basic drugs, and they are usually referred to private pharmacies for their prescription. However, with the many of these pharmacies operating illegally or potentially selling fake drugs, then that leaves the average person in a difficult situation. Solomon Kawesa, NTV.